And then exhale through your mouth.
Taunya, how do you want the lights?
Awesome.
Is that good? Yeah.
That's good. That's
okay.
Good. So your feet should be flat on the floor. There's sitting thing here. And
no,
Mo. You should,
you can let go.
That's good. That's
yeah.
Good. Yeah.
Yeah.
Your feet should be,
oh, yeah.
Should be flat on the floor if they can reach the floor. Some people are really short. And you should sit up. Your hands should be like on your thighs or wherever you have them during meditation.
That's good.
Yeah, how many meditators do we have in here? Okay. So this vibration, the harmonics, will bring you into meditation. Do not try to figure it out what's going to happen next. That's what you try to do in life. Is try to figure things out. If you just allow it to happen and just ride it out, it usually comes out like you never thought it would, and you've already set up your barriers by your thinking, by your mind, thinking too much. So this is also a lesson in how to receive your messages. So let's take a nice deep breath in. Expand your solar plexus. And exhale. Nice and long and long. Breathe in nice and deep. Thank you. I
Harmonious.
Harmonious. Kids playing together, and you don't know what you're going to play, but you got your toys, and you're going to go there somewhere. I just can't play with my kids.
Anytime. I like the
first one. You complement each other very well. Mm-hmm. So when you feel yourself clenching, or just remember, because I have to remember too, just to relax my knees. I have a tendency, but I have to relax my shoulders, breathe, keep myself open, not to. It's something like childbirth. Now, you men have not been to childbirth, but the more you allow nature to happen, and childbirth is part of nature. And you see, like the giraffes, they just drop their babies, and they stand up and like, okay, you know? So we've been taught to fear, to get nervous, to
be anxious.
To be anxious, we've been taught to hate. So we want to dispel what we've been indoctrinated into and allow our power to come to us. But in order to allow that to come to us, we have to be open. We have to be open, and don't listen to your mind too much, because your mind can drive you crazy. Literally, it can hold you back. Listen to what your body is telling you. Listen to how you feel. The skin is your biggest organ. The skin can feel more. When you walk into a room, you feel like, oh, I don't know about that.
Yeah.
That's your vibration combining with another vibration. Listen to it. Listen to the skin. not so much the ears, but listen to your skin, because your skin is the biggest organ, and it vibrates, and it vibrates out, and it receives. Okay. So if you're listening to, especially with these bowls, you feel the vibration, and you feel the harmonics combining with your harmonics and your vibration. In order for that to happen fully, you have to be open and not resist the childbirth, not clench. When the midwife told me, stop making faces, stop, it's not in your face, she said, she said, relax your face. I said, okay. And concentrate on the deed at hand. And help that baby to come out. No, for real. Because I was like, you know, that's what you see in the movies. And then that's the other thing. We've been taught so much nonsense. This other lady down the hall was screaming and hollering,
hey, you stop that bitch! I'm gonna kill you!
I said, what's going on down the hall? She said, well, she's having a baby. I was like, really? So when she told me to relax my face, I can concentrate on the contraction and to push with the contraction. I mean, I had birthing glasses, but you know, when you actually get there, when she said relax my face, I was like, and assist in pushing you. Come in, and then I was like, okay, I got another contraction. I can push that. Okay, hey, get ready. We send the head, She had a cheering session. People were coming in the room, go, what's going on?
Yeah, we send the head.
So she won. No wonder she's in show business. She had an audience when she was coming out. So allow nature to happen naturally. Don't get in the way. I say that as an example. So allow this vibration to go with you and take you through a higher part of yourself, a higher vibration of yourself. Don't get stuck. That's another story. Don't get stuck. What you say is very important. What you put out to the universe is very, very important. Even what you think, because what you think, you end up saying, and it's already created. So the universe is vibration. In the beginning, there was the word, it was the Big Bang. That's a vibration. That's sound. So I'm not going to get on God. But that's another story. Vibration. Vibration. Harmonics. You have your own harmony in your body.
Get it together, people. Get the harmony together. Hum, sing. Get it together.
And then you find life, you know, you can get over that chaos that we created. And some of you felt that the chaos was good. It felt good. Did you, anybody feel the chaos felt good? Of course you were. I noticed Anne Marie was smiling. You had a dumb look on your face. I was like, and all that's good. All that's good.
I was all in the sand playing. I was such a little girl. It was having fun. At one point, I just was like, just wanted to go. The little girl was just like, come on, let's have some fun.
Great. Might as well have fun.
I didn't want to come back.
Huh?
I didn't want to come back.
You didn't want to come back?
No.
Of course not. Yeah. But this is, here's the thing about this, too. Because the water in your body is an imprint. You can go back anytime you want. You can just allow the water in your body to bring you back to that point. Wherever you were, the water in your body already knows. So you can bring yourself back. Allow the water, the imprint in your body, in the water, to bring you back. It just takes being still sometimes. We're so busy. Next! Especially in the city. If you don't have a bowl, pick one sound out of all the chaos in the city and just focus on that one sound and relax the muscles of your face, relax your body, be ready to receive. And if you happen to fall back during this, then that's good. But you have to give yourself permission to allow this vibration to move you. Mm-hmm. And it moves the water in your body. And I've seen people move in ways that, in yoga positions, that I know they couldn't do. A lady moved all the way back. She went all the way back like a snake on the chair. She's just, and I said, oh, you have, you do yoga. This is beautiful. I mean, you're a yoga master? She said, no, but I had a backache when I came in and it's gone. Allow it to happen. Allow it to happen. Allow life to happen. Take the W word. It's a curse word.
Four letters.
Huh?
Four letters?
No, five. The W word. Worry.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't forget the other.
Eliminate.
Okay.
Might as well be a four letter word, right?
Well, yeah. How do you
know what
that word?
Okay,
that's enough for me, preacher.
So,
okay.
as all you may or may not know, Taunya and Cathy are volunteers. They're volunteers for My Second Breath is the organization. MySecondBreath.org is the website. And we accept donations. So if you'd like to leave a love donation, just leave it in the big bowl. One of the big giant bowls. And thank you so much for coming out.
Yes, thank you so much. And I have flyers about the retreat in Jamaica.
Oh,
and
yes, coming up, a retreat in Jamaica for January.
Yeah, January 17th through 22nd.
That's my birthday.
But if you register before or on November 1st, and it doesn't say it there, but if you register before or on November 1st, there's a discount.